In experiment number 3, you'll be using some volumetric ware and doing a determination of density of a solid and a liquid unknown. There are 3 pieces of glassware that are used in this experiment. One is a graduated cylinder. This is a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder. And it has markings to the every 0.25 milliliters. And so the manufacturer tells us that we can record the volume to the tenth of a milliliter. So if you measure out 10 milliliters, you want to be sure and record, tack on that zero so that it's to the tenth. Second piece of equipment that you'll use is called a pipette. And typically you put a rubber bulb up here and you suck liquid up into the pipette. This is a 10 milliliter pipette, and up here in the narrow section it's got a line, and you'd normally put the bottom of the meniscus right on that line. And because it's in this restricted area, the manufacturer tells us that we can record the volume to the hundredth. So when you come to that part of the experiment, be sure and record 10.00 milliliters for the volume of the pipette. The burette is designed to deliver variable volumes of liquid. It has markings to the tenth, so that means if we follow the rule, one more place than the number of markings is what we can estimate. So with the burette, we'd record to the hundredth. Up here in these 2 cases, the manufacturer told us what the accuracy is. Down here, we apply the rule of thumb, one more place than the number of markings. Let's look at some more information. We'll be checking the accuracy of these pieces of volumetric ware by weighing the water samples that we measure out, and we'll be using the fact that 1.00 grams of water is equal to 1.00 milliliters. So it enables us to weigh things and to check the accuracy of volumes. I want to give you a little heads up about places that you might miss points or lose points. And the most common errors are, again, dealing with significant figures. I don't think you'll have any trouble reading the values and the burette and so forth, but interpreting the numbers maybe will cause you a little bit of difficulty. So again, remember that for multiplying and dividing, you count significant figures. For adding and subtracting, you count decimal places. And in some cases, you'll be rounding. So review your experiences with rounding too. And I'd like to give you one tip. A common phone call that we get is that there's no photo for the burette on sample 2, the initial reading. And that's because, well, let me show you the burette. You'd begin with an initial level up in this range, let out a certain volume of liquid. Down here's the final reading. That's sample 1. And then for sample 2, we use that final reading for sample 1 as the initial reading, let out some more liquid. Down here's the final reading for sample 2.